What's the current status of Aaron Rodgers in the Packers now that we're post June 1 later on today and something is potentially more likely than it would have been just yesterday, even though it seems like the Packers have no intention of moving this guy. So what do you got for me on that?
I would agree, no intention of moving him. I haven't checked the Instagram account of the actress whose name I forget that he's vacationing with.
Yes, it's Miles Teller's wife is what you're referring to right there. Okay.
So I'm sure she's very good. I just don't know what show she's in. I had not heard of her before she started posting about Aaron Rodgers. But I haven't checked her Instagram account recently to know if he's still in Hawaii. I don't get the sense that much has changed at all. And that's another one where, like, there's not much incentive to do anything right now. Like, yes, the Packers, and, you know, they've been trying to get a deal done. I know they would really, really, really like to get an extension done that makes him happy to kind of end this issue. I just don't know that anything happens soon. Like, is, you know, the deadline for mandatory minicamp, is that a real deadline? Like, I don't know.
Let me pause you right there then, Ian. Okay, let's stop right there. So you know the Packers want him to sign a contract that will make him happy, correct? That's what you're saying. So then why wouldn't Aaron Rodgers want to sign a contract that would make him happy? Is it simply because that contract should have been offered to him the minute they lost the NFC Championship game and he was wondering about his future, and it did not come because of whatever reasoning that caused him to feel the way that that has been reported for him to feel and that he confirmed with Kenny Mayne 1 week ago last night? I mean, is that what is this, that he wanted it when he wanted it and it didn't come and he's pissed and he's now going to make him wait? Is that basically a way to look at this right now?
Well, I sort of think about it like I do with a lot of contract negotiations. And, you know, this is not the first negotiation to get personal and heated, I would say.
Sideways.
I don't know that he hasn't – I don't know that he's not signing it. I just know that he hasn't agreed to it yet. Like, maybe they haven't done a deal that's good enough. You know, I mean, that's – I see this all as a – you know, there's plenty of other parts of it, but I see it in part as a negotiation. So the fact that he hasn't accepted a deal just means their offer isn't good enough yet, or he's not ready to accept what is their current offer. You know, so they can make this work financially. They can make this work contractually. They can make it so he has enough guaranteed money so he's not worried about Jordan Love supplanting him ever, so he can retire on his own terms. I mean, these are the sorts of things he wants.
Right.
I just don't know that they're there yet. And that was interesting to me in the Kenny Mayne interview. Was he didn't close the door on anything.
No, I mean, he kicked the can down the road. The way that I termed it is he turned up the heat on Gutekunst. Like, he is, I don't think that this goose, if you will, of being Gutekunst, is remotely cooked enough for Rodgers. I mean, we're gonna get that goose cooked even more when he's out there golfing with the scientist, as Tom Brady's Instagram account referred to, Bryson DeChambeau.
That's like, gonna be great.
I mean, July 6th is gonna be a date where, you know, Brady and Phil will get in Aaron's face and have fun and with his situation, and he'll make a couple comments that'll be caught on a hot mic that works, because I mean, that's just gonna turn that thing up to Spinal Tap 11, as far as I'm concerned, because that's gonna be right a couple weeks before training camp hits, and we're going to be wondering if he's going to show up. So that's my question for you: is if you're wondering if the terms are not well, you know, to Rodgers' satisfaction, then Green Bay's desire to get him signed long term or to a contract that it makes him satisfied, you know, the only way that does that is to make Jordan Love inoperable as his successor in the first iteration of his professional contract, basically blowing up the clock in the manner that he said he threw a wrench into it with an MVP season.
Yeah.
You know, I think that this is the rational conversation to be had right now, is to try and read some tea leaves here, Ian.
I mean, I don't think any of that is wrong. Because that's sort of, I think, what he wants. And look, Rodgers blew up the sort of time situation anyway.
Yeah.
Kind of like Tom Brady did. Like, I'm sure the Patriots would have loved to have a succession plan of Tom Brady and Jimmy Garoppolo.
Right.
Sorry, Brady screwed all that up. And Rodgers screwed it up too, because he probably had his best season, you know, maybe except for the Super Bowl year. Like, he was awesome last year. And the previous year he had not been as good. And he was like, yeah, maybe you don't. And now they have to recalibrate, which to me is all okay. But again, like, you got to, you know, if you're the Packers and you want this thing done, like, you got to prove it contractually. Probably, like you said, making sure that Jordan Love is not an issue for Rodgers moving forward through his current contract or something like
that. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.